それから続いて少し話が飛びますけれども、図の3のところに移りたいと思います。で、我が国における食生活の高度化、多様化が進みます中で、食料の自給率が最近、近年一貫して低下しておりまして、2006年、39% となっております。先進国の中でも大変低い水準にあります。で、これにつきましては日本人の食生活が戦後大きく変化いたしまして、国内で自給可能な米の消費量が大幅に減少しております。一方、輸入に依存する畜産物あるいは油脂類の消費が大変大きく伸びておりまして、そうしたことが背景に挙げられます。それから続いて、図の4になりますけれども、国民の必要とする食料を安定的に供給すると、あるいは不足の事態における食料安全保障を確保するということから、国内農業生産を食料供給の基本として位置づけております。可能な限りその維持拡大を図っていくことが課題となっております。さらに加えて輸入の安定化あるいは備蓄ということも一緒に合わせて考えているところでございます。
If I may jump forward to chart 3. In Japan, we have seen our dietary habits becoming increasingly sophisticated as well as diversified. The food self-sufficiency ratio have continued to decline. In the fiscal year 2006, it has come down to only 39%, which is the lowest level amongst all the industrialized or the major industrialized countries. We have seen the Japanese dietary pattern changing significantly ever since the ending of the Second World War. We have seen a dramatic reduction in the amount of consumption of the rice which can be produced within Japan. On the other hand, we have seen a dramatic increase in the import of the livestock, such as dairy goods and such, as well as the edible oil and the fat. If I could also turn to chart the 4, we had the need to thus bring forward a stable supply of food, which is needed by the Japanese people, and also to ensure for the food security in preparation for any emergencies. We have positioned the domestic agricultural production to be at the very basis for the food supply. So as much as possible, we would like to maintain the level as well as expand the level of the food production. We would also like to try to stabilize the import of food.